Go get my hair cut first, and then I gotta head on over to maybe get some stuff from the grocery store, and then head on to work. But anyway, how's everybody doing today? I'm doing okay. I've been kind of going back and forth with some members of my family when it comes to truck driving schools. There is a truck driving school here in Springdale, but it's nothing compared to either Prime or CR England or Swift or CFI or any of those other truck driving schools. It's a small little rinky-dink school, and it's a technical institute that basically goes over stuff maybe some decent mechanics. What I'll do is I'll put Prime or at CFI or at Swift or at CR England. It's nothing like that. If you can imagine, they have maybe one or two trucks. And during this time, I don't even think when I went to it, I went through pre-trip inspection or anything like that. Maybe either because it wasn't required at the time, or that they just kind of skipped over that, and I don't even think actually worked. So basically, it was outside, their simulator was outside, and it wasn't that much of a thing to look at, in my opinion. I don't like to have to be in a small little environment that basically probably doesn't cover half the stuff that either Prime or CR England. My brother said that's a good economical thing. Pay for the transportation, your CFI, or for that matter, Prime, they would pay for the transportation getting up there. The only difference between CFI and Prime is Prime, I'd have to pay at least $155, but that is because of the permit and to get the CDL license. So I think it's probably about $55 for the permit, and another maybe $100 for the license. So don't quote me on that, but that's what I think. You can either do refrigerated, flatbed, or tanker. Tanker being something that's not hazmat. Something like maybe milk or any kind of liquid like that. That's one thing. Now with CFI, it looks like it's mainly refrigerated. Now with CR England, I think it's refrigerated and maybe box, and Swift, I think it's probably refrigerated and box. But with CFI, after I get my license, my CDL license, I'd have to try and go and get hazmat endorsement, which doesn't bother me. And there's a Luke Thompson truck just passed. That's the other thing is, yeah. There is Luke Thompson Trucking. Luke Thompson and Sons Trucking. and that's in Huntsville. And that's not very far from here. As a matter of fact, I am planning on going to Springfield this Saturday. So I'm going to be going and going by Lou Thompson and Sons Trucking, so y'all can see it. And I have been going by there a couple times when I was on my motorcycle. And it's a pretty neat place. I mean, it's just right off the highway. Can't miss it. So that's what I am planning on doing. So we'll get two for the price of one this Saturday. So that's what I'm planning on doing. But anyway, well, it looks like I'm here. So I am going to cut this vlog short, and I will talk to you all later. Okay, y'all. Well, $7 haircut. So, well, I am on my way to work. Took a little longer than expected. But at least I've got my hair cut. Now it's just a matter of getting to work. So anyway, so I am going to maybe go by the go by NTI so you all can see, but I'm not going to do that today. I'll probably do that tomorrow, and that way you all can see how much of a rinky-dink operation it is, and that, well, not as intense as Prime or CFI or CR England or Swift. It's nothing like that. As a matter of fact, it's, like I said, it's kind of rinky-dink. Yeah, I just wish this stupid light would turn green. At least I got my haircut done, and I am off to work. So, I'm kind of looking forward to the day that I go and I drive for Prime or CFI. Then start making money, because the way it is with any other place around here, I'm just struggling just to get by. Drive for Uber almost all the time. I don't know how I'd survive. I really don't. I don't know how I'd survive if I just drove for Uber. We'll see. Maybe we'll see. Looking forward to being out on the road as a truck driver. So and I think with Prime, they said I could have at least my two companions with me when I'm driving. But first, you gotta go through. The thing that concerns me about CR England is that, is there going to be a non-smoker trainer. That's what I'm concerned about. I do not want a smoker trailer or a smoker trainer. I don't think I could do that. Yeah, that's just me. And I think Joey Jones had talked about how he, I think, had waited about, what was it, 4 weeks for a trainer. So I need a trainer, and I need a trainer quickly. I am not going to put up with that. Prime, on the other hand, they'll pay me $200 a week, at least for the first week, and then we'll see what happens after that. But I've got to where I think I've got enough money saved up to where 1 month, maybe 2 months, would be good. At least until I'm, you know, full fledged driving. So. We'll see. But, man, this light seems to take forever. Okay, so, anyway, that's one of the things that concerns me. I mean, I've been hearing so many, I guess, horror stories about waiting for trainers. Other places, and I'm sure Swift would do the same thing. Prime is going to do the same thing of getting an immediate trainer. And CFI, I'm not sure about. But that's what I need right now. I need a trainer, and I need to get trained. Need to get trained. I cannot afford to not be trained. So that's what I think. But I'm kind of looking forward to the trip up to Springfield, and it'll probably be this Saturday. So I'm looking forward to. That's all I've got for you for this vlog. Anyway, it is Renegade Biker 24, and I am in my 2017 Chevy Sonic, and I will talk to you all later.